warning about potential dangers of certain over-the-counter pain relievers. A study published in the British Medical Journal suggests drugs like ibuprofen and naproxen may increase your risk for having a heart attack. Our medical expert, Dr. Kevin Campbell, joins us live here in the studio. You're talking specifically about non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or better known as NSAIDs. Tell us more about this study.
So researchers reviewed data from studies that used healthcare databases in Canada, Finland, as well as in England. They analyzed almost 500,000 people, and of these, about 60,000 had a heart attack. The results showed that an increased risk of heart attack occurred as early as in the first week of taking an NSAID like ibuprofen, and the risk was greater with higher doses of NSAIDs. The greatest risk of heart attack was seen with NSAID use at a high daily dose for the first month. For ibuprofen, that was about 1,200 milligrams a day or 6 tablets in 1 day. Overall, taking NSAIDs showed a 20 to 50% increase in risk of heart attack when using them compared with not using these medications.
So why does ibuprofen have this effect on some people?
First of all, we must remember that this study was observational. It doesn't really prove cause and effect. Mm-hmm. However, you know, there are some theories about why this happened. One theory is that taking NSAIDs may increase your blood pressure and lead to fluid retention, may increase your risk for blood clots, and all of these things can precipitate a heart attack in those people who are predisposed to it.
All right, so what should we do when it comes to using these medications? Should we really take caution, or, you know, should people really worry?
You know, first of all, the NSAIDs that were studied were ibuprofen, naproxen, Celebrex, and diclofenac. You know, I wouldn't let this scare you away from using NSAIDs, but rather make you more mindful when you do take them. Mm-hmm. Talk to your doctor about using these drugs, and if you need them for chronic pain, you may want to discuss alternative therapies such as local steroid injections, physical therapy, and that sort of thing. The bottom line is that we got to think about risk and benefit when we take these drugs and any drugs, and really try to avoid high doses and long-term use.
And don't forget to count how many you've taken.
Exactly. Keep track of that sort of thing. It's very important.
All right, Doc. Thanks so much. If you'd like to learn more about this or you have any other health-related questions for Dr. Campbell, you can find it right there on our website and let him know. Maggie?
All right. Interesting stuff. Well, stay with us. We'll be back.